something in time.
Yeah, at the wrong moment. Yes.
A good moment for, yeah, for us, but yeah, at the wrong moment, yeah, for some of the interests in,
yeah,
the world.
Exactly. For, yes, this establishment which prevents science from acting scientifically.
Yes.
For maybe military reasons. We don't know why.
We don't know. Exactly. Yes. We don't know, but we would like to know. And
yes,
we think that science should be good for human beings.
Yeah. That I mean, human beings should be good for human beings.
Yes.
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 Everybody. Not
yeah,
just, you know. Yeah.
It is so great to have this discussion with you, I
thank
have to
you
say.
It has been reported that Dr. Ellis, from CERN said on to topic LSAG, the LHC security report nearly 2 years ago, there is no scientific motivation for these reviews. They are a foregone conclusion. How come that somebody like Dr. Ellis would say such a thing?
Yeah, I have a very good impression of Dr. Ellis at CERN.
Mm-hmm.
I never met him,
mm-hmm,
but he publicly accused me in a talk and said what he presented my paper, the first page,
mm-hmm,
and told the audience that this is absolute nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
And I was not happy,
mm-hmm,
but at least this was a fair statement.
Yeah.
And now the same person apparently has second thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
And so I have a second reason to admire him.
Yes. Yeah. That is like, I mean, if we look at this judge, what was again his name? Germany?
The Bundesverfassungsgericht.
Yes, and the judge, his name?
Papier.
Papier?
Hans-Jürgen Papier.
Hans-Jürgen Papier. And if we think of Dr. Ellis,
mm-hmm,
we got
John
two
Ellis,
people,
yes,
John Ellis from CERN, we got two people, two human beings,
yeah,
and
yeah,
two professionals that don't exactly say, yes, there's a danger, we have to do the safety conference, but they do something, that there seems to be some
they act fairly
message here.
Exactly, yes. Yeah. Yeah. It's a fair statement if a court says that no one on the planet wants to know. You see?
Yes.
That's wonderful.
Yes. That is interesting.
Yes.
No? So, I think there is really this issue of timing, because
yeah,
if the CERN wouldn't hurry,
yeah,
it would have enough time. There would be this judge, I think, one day who would
yeah
actually take the case.
Yes.
As Mr. Johnson, the
yeah
legal professor in,
yeah,
in
yeah
the U.S. said. And the other side, of course, the CERN maybe knows that too and tries to do it as fast as possible, making it more dangerous because they can't really see what happens. They have to really turn the machine up quickly. So this is a bit the difficult situation.
Yeah, it's almost tragic. It's almost a comedy. It's a piece,
yes,
of
tragic comedy. Tragic comedy. Yes.
Yeah, there's this Swiss poet who wrote about the physicists. What's his name? A piece.
Oh my God. For Sevilla, no? The Sevilla, Sevilla.
No, we will have to cut this out, yes.
No, we won't. We keep natural. The
yeah
sun wants to cut features out.
Yeah.
We just keep here and we
yeah
go.
Yeah,
yes,
right.
Like that.
Yeah.
Okay. So, some authors, this is a bit special, this question, I know, especially for scientists, but some authors write about the CERN LHC conspiracy. A hidden agenda. Daring talks about secret services being at the CERN, I don't know what. We even read a report about an apparent secret service infiltration. How much credibility do these reports have? I mean, they thought they say earthquakes could be, I mean, people talking to me on the street saying, you have seen so many earthquakes, the CERN has been on again. What do you think about these theories that I would say go a bit further
yeah
along
yeah
the road?
Yeah, you see, scientifically they would not hold water, of
mm-hmm
course.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that people's subconscious, so
mm-hmm
to speak, produces such not completely correct visions
yes
proves that the public is more intelligent than science. Sorry.
Yes, yeah, yeah, I understand what you mean. They can't really say, yes, it's all correct, it's certain.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But they feel that the CERN is able to do something which is dangerous.
Yeah.
So basically, they're starting to see symbolism here and there. And go,
one has to understand the language. It means mm-hmm. something a little bit different than what it says.
Yes.
And then it is correct.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Another theory that was, I think, two months or so ago, or maybe three, there are even actually two quite well-known scientists, I think. Another theory assumes that the LHC will never work because some force in the future will not let us destroy the world. I personally prefer to take care of safety regardless of some future force coming to protect us in the past.
Yeah.
And you?
I would say the same thing. This is, again, pseudo-scientific statements which carry a deeper truth. There is this Swiss psychoanalyst, C.G. Jung, who claimed that there is something like a public sensitivity which goes deeper than the surface shows.
Yeah.
And I would see this also in the same context, that the public and these scientists try to say something which they are not quite successful at expressing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And it shows the deep fears of people.
Yes.
And science should not make children feel fear.
No, I don't. I mean, that is very personal, I know, but I don't think it's okay if my daughter comes home from school and says, "Oh my God, they talk about the CERN." Yeah.
Yeah.
If we want to bring science forward, and I think the best way for scientists, and I think for the profession of these scientists, especially at the CERN, to have a future and to be well regarded citizens, is to take care also of these fears.
It's a single word: honesty.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Openness. Why not say, here is the evidence against this, and this is the evidence for it, and everyone can say, everything is on the table.
Yes.
Why keep it under the rug? Yes.
Yes. Exactly. So, if we could do that, if we could do this safety conference, which Professor Ressler asks since 23 months, and I keep asking, and many others ask for, if we could do this, and as you mentioned, this doesn't have to take years. It might take more than a week, actually, to be sure that it's not dangerous or dangerous.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I mean, we can't guarantee it's done in 5 days.
Yeah. But presumably, the first weaknesses we show very early on.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked Prince Charles to chair it, actually. And we could mention that. It is on this public.